The conversation that I wish to do today is about what is the existence. If we lose the epistemology for the true existence, we have only to say, at the beginning, that it is the possibility of the existence that is the base, the same base of the existence. In fact, if the existence should not have the power to exist, it doesn't exist. We have a thing in our science that is the mathematics, and also in the mathematics there is the presence of the powers. The powers use the numbers, and when this number is made by one alone, that is the 10 number, we can say that the number 10 has the possibility, in the power based on this 10 number, to exist as a power. In fact, by a power based on number 10, we have all the numbers. Number 1 is 10 raised to 0. Number 10 is 10 raised to 10. Number 2 is 10 raised to 2. This is the first way of the power to exist. 10 multiplied by itself, that is 10 squared, is the beginning to have the number 2 if we put in action the inverse of a power based on number 10. In fact, 10 raised of 2 is 2 only if we use the decimal logarithm of this power. In fact, logarithm of 10 raised to 2 gets directly the number 2. We pass from a power based on 2 to the simple dimension 2, squared dimension, acting the inverse observation of the power 10 raised to 2. The inverse observation is just the logarithm of 10 raised to 2. You know that in the dynamic law, the third principle is named of action and reaction. And that this is the fundament of every action. It is always a binary system of two relative opposition, the action and the equal and the inverse action named reaction. We can see that power 10 raised to 2 is the action corresponding to the multiplication of 10 by 10, and that its result is 100 as the power of 10 raised to 2. But we, starting from the action whose result is 100, we can relatively, in way equal and contrary, have the number 2 by the logarithm, the decimal logarithm of 10 raised to 2. In this way, when there is as fundament a power, we can arrive to the perception, to the relative perception of the world acting the inverse of this power, the logarithm. It is the way by which we have afterwards a relative perception of the fundamental power that existing as 10 multiplied 10 multiplied 10 multiplied 10 equal to 10 raised to 3, and have directly the number 3. Now the result in our mathematics of this calculation of the powers is the fundament of the power of ourselves to exist. To exist if we act, if we put in action the calculation based on the number 10 as the father of every number. In fact, if all the number n become by the logarithm of 10 raised to n, we can say without any doubt that 10 is the father of every number, and that we can have a relative perception of the fundament of a power that has the 10 number as a true God, and that our relative life is relative to this God that in our system of calculation is truly the number 10. We, if desire to control the truth of this affirmation, recurring to the idea of Jesus Christ, who said that God had three persons, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, we can truly have the result that if the Father is 10 rise to plus one, the Sun, having the same power 10 as its base, is 10 rise to minus 1. That is in the inverse direction of a creativity, because if the Father goes in this direction, in this positive direction, generating the sun that is 10 minus rise to minus 1, acts in the opposite direction, that brings again the sun in the Father's presence. The interaction between 10 as the Father and 10 rise to minus 1 as the Son is the absolute existence of the number 1. Number 1, if we desire to have the same base 10, is 10 rise to 0. In this way, the control that uses the Jesus Christ gospel to control my epistemologic words is confirmed, because as we can reason using the mathematics and have 10 as the father of every number of our possibility, in the same way the fundament is one only fundamental truth, that 10 rise to 0 is equal to 10 rise to plus 1 multiplied by 10 rise to minus 1. All this exists in power, and the mathematics is in the possibility to have these powers. So, existing this mathematic possibility as the real powers of the mathematics, power that I have said are based on 10 as on the Father, basing on these numbers, our mind can to have a can have a result, starting by the power in itself, as by a God, as from a God, we can have a relative perception going in the inverse direction, going in the relative perception that is equal and contrary to the reality. And this is most important, because if we all arrive to understand that our relative perception of the world is equal and contrary to the dynamic that exists as the absolute fundament, if we start from a power based on 10 for everything, for every number, and we cut away this base, using the calculation of the logarithms, we cut away Godfather and we base our perception of the world only on the dimensions of the index, of the exponent. What is the result of this? The result is that if we have a monomium that is one only object as a number, we can have the analysis of this unit by divisions. For example, starting from 10 raised to 10, we can arrive to 10 multiplied 10 raised to 9. We starting from 10 raised to 10, in first action, have divided in two parts, 10 and 10 raised to 9. But we are saying the truth because we have the interaction between 10 and 10 raised to 9. Because 10 multiplied 10 raised to 9 is 10 raised to 1 plus 9, that is 10 raised to 10. It is always 10 raised to 10, the quantity, and it is 1 alone. But the result of the division, if we have the inverse observation using only the index, starting from the product between 10 and 10 raised to 9, using the logarithm, we have only 1 plus 9. And the monomium now is a binomium, because we have introduced the addition, and when in a calculation we have the sign plus or minus, we have not yet a monomium, but a binomium, a polynomium. This is the way by which we have the perception of a world completely full of single unit. 1, 1, 1, 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. One atom, two atoms, all the universe made by single atoms. And this is a perception as a addition, but in the truth of its generation, it is 10 raised to 1 plus 10 plus n. And so this addition of the single part of the universe is one only unit, because it is based completely on the same cycle 10 as the base of this power. You see that in this situation in which we have that all the things of the universe are the dimension of 1 plus 1 plus 1 of atoms, of persons, of things, of everything as addition one after the other, we have a common father that is the base 10 as the power having the universe as one only index. That is a addition of a single part of this unitary index, because this addition in the index is a product between single divisions of the unit. Single division of the unit multiplied among them is always one only unit. In this way, basing our existence on the possibility to exist as a power and as a subject, living subject, that have the possibility to reason using the numbers and using the powers, we, by simple result, because this is a possibility, this possibility can exist, having the possibility to exist. If the mathematics power exists in the resulting situation, they exist, and we exist as a count in action. You know that when a computer has this possibility, we have the possibility of the reason to exist. And we exist in the same wave using our reason that is in action exactly as we have the example, the practical example, in every computer of our world. And if we pay attention to the way in which the artificial intelligence goes on, we see that we have a file completely composed by two inversions, and in this way, using 1 and 0 as the to be and the not to be, we are in the possibility to have a file of indices 1 and 0 in the binary system of a possibility to speak. For example, we can, using the point and the line, we can speak using the Morse system, and in the same wave we can to have the possibility to have a reason of this file of binary date if we have a software of our mind to transform the mix between the to be and the not to be, or between the one and the zero, to transform its giving form to algorithms. And so, in the same way in which a file named DVD is and the possibility to be shown as a movie, we can, starting from this DVD as our fundament, we, basing on this fundament as on our own DVD, can have the representation, the real representation of our world, using the ideas, the forms that our mind has the possibility to put in existence. And we know that the light, that the colors are just thing in this system of representation, because the light is not a thing in itself, but only a conception. The colors are not things in itself as color, but the color is our system to represent the difference of rhythms, of length of wave. At the origin, there is the wave. The wave is the binary representation of two inverse situation. If we have one line as the latching of movement, we can have the egg of the wave if we have the down of the wave. Up and down are only one wave, and it is the binary representation of a positivity, as what is more than the one of the latching of difference. If we have this latching of equilibrium, of balance, we must have also this, because the one existence in positive can exist only on the base of the inverse relativity. It is the same thing. If we have a zero, we can have minus one and plus one. If we have this binary consistence, this binary presence, we have something as a wave. And afterward, our mind, basing on the length of this wave, more or minus, is in the ability to transform it in light colors if the length of the wave is in the range of our possibility to perceive it. In this way, we have the possibility to perceive something is in the fundament there is the wave, and only afterward we relatively to this fundament of a consistence we can have the representation of our mind. But we say that in a wave there is up and down, up and down, up and down. We have never two up, one after the other. But we, in our nature, see that in the object that afterward we perceive, there is a file containing, for example, 1 1 1 0 0 0, where one after another one after another one seem as two consecutive up of the wave. But we have to understand why this happens. We can observe the difference in the object if we start from our mind that has the operativity, that has the possibility to be a well-ordered wave. If we are well-ordered in our wave, we, using this order, can observe the apparent lacking of order of a DVD in which we have one, one, one after the other, and not 1 0 1 0 1 0. Only if we have the possibility to have this order of a 1 0 1 0 1 0, we, using the order, can observe the apparent lacking of order of a file that is something that in appearance, that apparently is not ordered. But this lacking of order is only the consequence of our perception of a single file that exists, as we have seen, in the unitary power of a one completely based on n, that is 10 raised to 10, which is the fundament of everything, but that we can observe using the opposition, using the wave, the vibration that in this way, starting from one only unit, is transformed in a addition of single orders in this direction that are in the same system of the unitary representation. It is well ordered as an absolute system of representation using the binary system between the to be and the not to be, and arrives to a lot of divisions between or among all the possibility to exist. If there is the possibility to exist, we have something as an almighty God, an omnipotent God. We can put in action the existence of everything. Everything translated in single files in this direction as single files of the binary system of the representation. And acting in this way, we are with the possibility to have every existence. If we observe one alone, we can say that it is not in order, because 1 1 0 0 0 1 appears completely lacking of the well-ordered wave that exists as our mind. But if we have something, we can observe something that is different. If we have something that observes something that is completely equal, it seems to not exist. Because the power is something as the mass. The mass is the push of something against something other that as a reaction pushes it to stop. And so among this and this there is the push. But if also this is in the same movement, apparently the push there is not. In this way, the vacuum and what appears full of matter is a consequence of the relative mass that is advancing in the time. What advances in the time and it is perfectly equal is not perceived by the latching of mass, of action. And so we have the simple representation of the world based only on the existence of what have a mass, a push. And this push, we say, is just what exists, for example, in the file having 111. We have the push of our mind, because in the time in which our mind is 1 0, the object is 1 1. And in this way, we can observe the difference. it is by this reason that we have the observation very easy, because if I have a representation of this shape containing all the pixel of my plane of representation, I have to do a quantity to every point. But if we perceive only the difference from a section and a new section, the difference appears as the movement. And so only when there is an apparent movement, we in the vacuum perceive the existence of something that appears to have a mass. And if it do not appears having a mass, it is not perceived. It appears as the vacuum. So, our universe that appears made by a full mass and a lot of vacuum is not in this way, because also the vacuum is a plane of quantity, but it does not appear by the latching of a movement appearing as a real mass in action, in relative action. In this way, we have the perception of everything based, I repeat, on our representative system that is logarithmic, decimal logarithmic, because the father of everything is the number 10, is the base having the power to exist in a division that is in interaction. Division and interaction is the same unit that appears as a lot of fragments, as single photograms of a movie. We have the possibility by the 10 cycle to have the cycle 10 as the cycle of the representation of the so named present time, because we in our present time can start from the 10 cycle. And so if we have it in the three dimensions of the space, we have that all the mass present in this representative system is 10 raised on 3, is 10 multiplied 10 multiplied 10, is 1000 unit. And what is more than this appears as a subsequent time, as a new time, apparently different by that is in the precedent situation, because there is a relation among the single times. Because the time, when it is put in relation to the unit, is the time, for example, 1/10, that is the unit of the system that is based on the 10 raised to 1. But when the time is in 1/10, we have 10/10 as the unit. And so, we, by first, have the possibility to have the imagination of our universe. Because if we start from the absolute of the ten, and we perceive it in a unitary wave, that is using its inverse, that is its 1/10, we have that 1/10 exists in 10/10 as 9/10 of movement of 1/10. In this way, 9 is the unitary representation of the absolute 10 that is divided in all its tenths. And 1/10 is present as the existing mass of movement, and 9 is the energy of the movement when the energy is put in action, and having the time 9 times to exist, by existence in power that has in the beginning one mass, by 9 movements of this energy, becomes 9 masses that have their acceleration till they become 10. 10 is the most acceleration of the 10th time, because the most acceleration of 1/10 is put in action when 1/10 becomes 10/10, that is the unit. And in this way the time is exactly the time of the division of 1 in 10/10. Is a time, because we, to perceive the unit of the space existent in its unit, has the necessity of the existence of 10/10. And in this wave, every 1/10 is a single fragment, a single representation of 10 different presence time. In this way, we have the representation the real unitary representation of the absolute 10 using the sum of this 10. That is the tenth. It is the time of the representation of the Father 10. And in this way we have that we have the representation of everything by the power that has three orders of power. That is 10, rise to 10, rise to 10, a trinity of 10. 10 rise to 10, rise to 10 is equal to 10 rise to 100, because the power of a power is the multiplication of the numbers. The power multiplied by a power is the addition. The power of the power is the multiplication of the index. So 10 rise to 10 rise to 10 is 10 rise to 10 multiplied 10 is 10 rise to 100. And 100 is the general God of our representation, because we have this quantity as the section 10 multiplied 10 of our going on. It is the unitary section. 10 rise to 100. And we see another time that the Trinity of God, in this case, is 10, rise to 10, rise to 10. We perceive everything in this way. The universe is put in action, in representative action, dividing the absolute 10 in line by the 9 units of movement. I have said that we perceive only by the movement, and the only movement in the 10 cycle of one mass that exists in its position is the 9 movement of that one mass. Well, if we divide this fundament, this 10 absolute, in 9 units, we have that 10 divided by 9 is 1.11111 forever. I have said to you that we perceive the time presence using the decimal quantity, the tenth, and in 1.11111 we have always the existence of infinite tens. One always tens of the precedent 10. And in this way we have the fundamental existence of the mass as 1/10 of its precedent unit. When afterward the physics 2 centuries ago had the idea to put in action units that were existing in the 10 cycle we have put in action also in our system to represent the mass of our time in the same system of our mental representation, of the representation of our mind. And in this way we really became able to have a well ratio between our system to represent the world with our system to represent it by our mathematics mind. By the division of 10 divided 9 and equal to the eternal 10th, we have the infinite existence in the space of the infinite universe, infinite in the space and infinite in the decimal time of the mass. And we see that starting from the absolute number 10 and is unitary perception only using the movement of the mass and its acceleration, we become able to represent the existence of something that appears to be infinite in the space and in the time. We are not in this way in the doubt and say how is possible that our universe is infinite one. Really, the infinite existence of our universe is something that appears to be impossible. Can the universe be infinite? But is real one the infinite in our definitive situation of our present? It can, if our present is a point of the division of 10 ninths, and if the future is the future action of the division, and exactly in the same representative system, the past is starting from the division the multiplication by the quantity that is in action to divide it by 9. And so 1.111 multiplied 9 becomes 9.999, and it is the relative past time of our presence, which is 1.111 in this time, but that has the infinite of the others 1.111 that are put in action when our mind put in action its division dividing 10 by 9. We perceive in this way the ratios of the math. In fact, if we put in action the ninth, we can have the way to count of the rulers, calculators, the nonio. In Italian language is said nonio. What uses the ninth? If we are in this way to control using the ninth, we can have the calculation. And it is the proof that we have the existence of the ninth time using the ninth, the nonio. The general and fundamental system that once the architects had in action before the existence of the computers. Well, I stop here this argument because it is so general and so big one that if I start to speak I never stop my words. But in this first moment in which I put the question of the possibility of the existence, I repeat, the possibility exists by the existence of the powers of the math that are based exactly on the 10 number, and by the logarithms of the power we have the perception of a world that is based on the dimensions that are the index, only the index of this common base 10 that is cut down by us in the same way in which we cut away God by our word and say that this fundament of our father doesn't exist. But if God is the fundament of the existence, it exists since we see that we exist. It is the proof of Cartesio when he said, I think and so I exist. But since I am a relative existence, relative to its absolute existence, we cannot cut away the fundament of our existence. We cannot cut away our fundament, our God. And God, the real God, in its way of to act, is using the mathematics ratio and by the powers has the power to put in the relative perception going away by contradiction of this power using the decimal logarithm. Goodbye.